This is my own personal experience. I grew up in different small rural towns in Arizona. And in that, I would see something that was very common. And it would be that neighbors would have families of children. And they would be engaged into the small community, and they would go to school or churches or other things that were part of small communities. And so someone, and I was the oldest, so maybe the oldest of all the siblings would go to school first or some function. And so they develop a reputation. Ah, you're the Smith boy or the Taylor girl. Oh, okay. And then all of a sudden their brother or sister shows up behind them. And there's a tendency to stereotype. Ah, your brother was excellent and smart. He was great in math. We expect that from you. Or we know that you were a little handful. You were the class clown. So we think that we want to be sure that you behave that you're not like your brother or sister. And so what would happen is that people categorized, stereotyped. Whether it was good or not good, there was that expectation. And so I'm older, so I don't have that experience. But when I talk to people that are maybe born in the middle or later on in their family lives there, sometimes that happens to them, that they don't get to be who they really are right away. They kind of have to fight that stereotyping, that way that, oh, that's who you are, or why not aren't you like your brother or sister? Jesus is experiencing the same thing in today's gospel, the stereotyping. Now, here's Jesus that he goes to a special place with his disciples there, and he asks them a question: who do people say that I am? What's the word? What's the scuttlebutt that's going out there? Now, remember, in the ancient Mediterranean world, they operate differently. People came to discover who they were by what people told them. Not like us, where I'm going to be this individual. This is who I'm going to be. I've discovered that this is what I like. This is who I am. Jesus grew up in the ancient Mediterranean world and probably asked the question that everyone in that world said. What are people saying about me? That's how they came to discover who they were. And so when Peter finally gets that and says, you are the Son of God, oh, okay, you get it. And so 2,000 years later, we as Catholics say, well, that's the Pope, that's authority, the church gets to do that. And yeah, that is a kind of a foundation, but there's something that Peter teaches all of us here that we can all relate to you. See the image of God in everyone. That's not an easy thing to do, especially when we struggle with stereotyping. Jesus is told, oh, you're Jesus of Nazareth. That had a whole inclination because in Nathanael in John's gospel says, oh, Jesus from Nazareth. Can anything good come from Nazareth? In other words, it's full of hicks, people that aren't very bright. And Jesus is kind of like that then. When he comes from Nazareth, we know who he is. He's nothing like that at all. He's really not anything special. That's a stereotype. Another one is, oh, we know your father. He works with his hands. He was a day laborer. He does all this stuff. So you're probably like your father. You're too well known. How can you be the Messiah? We know your dad. We know you work. You have office hours. Huh? You do things with your hands. How about you are the son of Mary? That we know your brothers and sisters. You're too familiar with us. You come from that family, and this is how your family acts. This is who you are. Being stereotyped, being told, it's easier. Life is difficult. There's a lot of challenges. Why just have to take energy to discover, to listen and learn about people? It's easier just to categorize them, to stereotype and saying, yep, all these people are alike. That's where you're from. That's who you are. And that's why Peter does a powerful thing. Who do you say that I am, Peter? You are the image of God. You are the image of God. And that's what Christians are called to do, to see in all types of people that we have an image, that the image of God is within each one of us. The problem that we have in our society today is we don't listen well to people. When there are groups that have serious concerns for themselves and for the country or other people, they bring those up, whether it's gender, whether it's race, whether it's economic class, whether it's just dignity of being a human being and how to be treated properly. Opponents of that just take their logo, their standing, their motto, and they turn it around. And what they do is they repeat it over and over negatively. And then it's sold in a different way. You're against our country. You're not patriotic. You're not a real Christian. Oh, you don't really believe in God because we don't listen. We're not really interested in hearing what people are going through and what their concerns. We regurgitate what we've been told over and over. It's bad. It's a bad model. There's a bad group of people. They shouldn't be listened to. That's stereotyping. That is not listening. Now, listening doesn't mean agreement what people think in their opinion. Trust me, I listen to a lot of people and I don't agree with everyone. But that doesn't make me a bad person. But I never rob them of dignity. That's the issue. That people go overboard and saying, because I don't agree with you, because you have this stance, then you're not a human being. You shouldn't be listened to. In fact, you should be yelled at, flipped off, told to get out of the country because you don't think that way. And we don't treat people in the image that they're called to be. We stereotype. And we just do one thing because it's easier to live that way. You're all like that. Oh, you people should move away. Oh, you know. And that's a great way to live because you don't have to think. You don't have to work hard. And you know what? Worse yet, you don't have to give people dignity. See, you can talk about today's gospel meaning that we have a pope and the church gets to make all these rules. That's fine. I don't know if it affects everyone in the pews today. And I don't think you're going to be talking about that at breakfast. But here I know what you're going to talk about. I don't like being stereotyped. I don't like people assuming what I think. I don't like not being given dignity. I don't like not being recognized or listened to. Or I like categorizing. I'm okay not giving people dignity because I don't see the image of God because they're sinners, they're bad, they're all going to hell anyway. Well, that's how some people model, and some people call themselves Christian in modeling that. So here's the challenge. Can we overcome stereotyping? Can we be better listeners? Listening doesn't mean agreement, that you agree with their opinion or their way of life. Listening means I will not take away the dignity of God within you. Jesus is asked, is it lawful to pay taxes to Caesar? And he asked for a coin. And he asked in that coin, whose image is this? And everyone responded, Caesar's. And then Jesus says, well, give to Caesar what is Caesar's, but give to God what is God. And what is God? The human heart. And all of you here today, no matter where you're at spiritually, the image of God is in each one of you. All of you. No one is exempt. You belong to God. Because the image of God is imprinted in you. The problem with stereotyping is it robs people of that image. All of you belong to God. The image of God is in everyone here today at Liturgy.